This is an Eye on Annapolis bonus podcast.
Joining us today on WhatsApp, actually, this is the first time I've done this, is a man whose voice is instantly recognizable. He's the voice behind Tempted, Black Coffee in Bed, Cool for Cats, Up the Junction, and my personal misheard lyric song of all time, Pulling Muscles, Mr. Glenn Tilbrook, of the founding member of Squeeze. How are you?
I'm good. How are you, John?
I'm awesome, man. And yes, I am among probably millions wondering, you know, who the hell is Michelle with Pulling Muscles? But what are you going to do?
Muscles, it's a shell.
It took me a while. I'll tell you, it was probably a good 8 years before I really figured that out. But Genesis and paper plates. It's paper lace. So we'll figure that out. First things first, you are coming to Annapolis, and this is so exciting, for a single show at Ram's Head on Stage on September 27th. And I did just peek before we hopped on the phone, and there are still a few tickets left. So anyone that's listening, go get them, ramsheadonstage.com. And this is one show that I am really psyched to see, because you and Chris Difford actually are Squeeze. And for those that don't know the origins, Chris Difford, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, but hung an ad for a guitarist, and you were the only one to reply, right?
Yeah, that is right.
And then what did he say? Like, okay, well, what the hell? Why not?
Why not? He had great songs. I had great songs. And when we wrote together, it was even better. So, you know, we're off to a flying start. It was a great meeting for me.
Gosh, and here we are 50 years later. But it's a good thing you answered the ad, and thank you.
Yeah, who'd have thought it?
Now, what would you have been doing otherwise? What if Chris had said, yeah, no, you don't quite cut it?
I think I would have been an internationally famous sculptor if I hadn't been in music. But I don't know, because I never actually took up doing anything to do with any other art than music. And that was always going to be my one way out and my one way forward. And, you know, I'm lucky that it happened. But we did work, and, you know, we worked a lot, and we were very diligent about writing. So, you know, I'm not saying we didn't deserve it, but we were also lucky.
You know, I do understand that you and Chris, your co-founder, have been performing a lot together, and, you know, sort of like a Squeeze light, if you will. But is he going to be joining you here in Annapolis?
No, he's not. This is entirely a solo show. It's something that he and I do quite often. And, you know, it's... I have those songs, and I have other songs that I've done outside of Squeeze and some covers. And generally when I do shows, I don't work with a set list. So, you know, the show can be a bit different every night. And I love the freedom of it. You know, with Squeeze, we always work with set lists, and that's great because we're a great band. But by myself, I can go in any direction I like.
Do you prefer to deal with a smaller venue or a larger venue? I guess it probably depends on what band you're playing with.
Yeah, you know what? For a long time now, after we, you know, our career took us out of major stadiums and into theatres and then clubs. And then, you know, so I've been all the way up and all the way down and back up again. We're doing big places now with Squeeze, and we've done some great shows over the last 2 years. You know, played the Hollywood Bowl, played the Madison Square Gardens, all that stuff. But I love doing club shows, and I've never wanted to stop doing that. It's a different experience, and the audience gets something different from it.
What can we expect to see here at Ram's Head on the 27th in Annapolis? I mean, is it going to be most of your solo stuff? I mean, I know you've had I don't want to say it's a brand new, I mean, it's a couple of years old, but Happy Endings, your most recent album.
Yeah. It's actually whatever happens on the night. So there's solo songs, you know, I think I've got five or six solo albums. And then, you know, Squeeze songs. Well, I've been really happy with the way that Squeeze has been. And my energy is devoted to that nowadays. But I love having the freedom to do whatever I like on the night. And I get that when I'm by myself.
You know, that's kind of cool that you could just sort of go without a set list. You get up there with the guitar, and you get up with the lyrics and what you've got going, and you just sort of tap into your catalog, I guess.
It's incredibly cool. And, you know, I think people like the unpredictability of it. And that's what I get from people who come see me. So, you know, I'm really happy to be doing it.
I'm sure you've been asked a million times about your musical influences, and I'm not going to really go there. But if you, as either Squeeze or Glenn Tilbrook solo, could do a double bill with any band or artist, living or dead, I guess, who would be your choice if we could somewhat wave a magic wand and put you on stage with somebody else?
Well, I'd like very much for that to be Jimi Hendrix, please.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I would love that. I love where he was at. He's such a great writer, as well, obviously, as a guitarist, and I loved his singing too. His writing always I found very inspirational.
You know, I noticed I was up on your website, and folks, I would do suggest you go to glenntilbrook.com, and that's two N's in Glenn and one L in Tilbrook. And you're partnering with the Trussell Trust, which supports food banks over in the UK for most of your UK shows?
Yeah, for all of them. I mean, I'd really like to find out some way to do that in America, but there's no unified thing there that I can find. But, you know, we're living in hard economic times for some people, and I find that people are generous if you ask them to contribute and give them something back. And the people who run food banks and people who contribute it, I think, have the biggest hearts. And I'm proud to work with people who do that, you know, because I have my endless admiration.
You know, we have the same issue here in America, and actually September is Hunger Action Month here in the United States, so you're coming in sort of at the tail end of that, and maybe I can talk to Ramshead into maybe putting in an ask for some food or cash donations for your show to benefit our local food bank.
Locals where it's at, you know, I mean, I love to do whenever I'm doing that or working with people, I always want it to stay local. That's a way to get things done.
No, absolutely. I'll mention that to them and see if we can add that in there, because it's the need is so great. And I mean, we like to think, you know, we're so fortunate that we have a roof over our heads and food in our cupboards. But there are so many people that are struggling to do that or don't have it. And if we can do it, and it doesn't take much. That's the thing that really, really gets me. It's not a whole lot. What else are you working on?
But right now, Chris and I have started writing, and we had like a 5-year break from doing that. And we just wrote something and recorded it for the first time last week as Squeeze. So I see that as the beginning of the new Squeeze record. So we've started work on that.
What would you say? When would that come out? Maybe in a year?
Well, I think that what we want to actually do is do two records. One would be a record of songs that we've done, you know, this year and next year, and the other one would be a record of songs that we wrote 50 years ago that never came out. And I'd like both of them to be musicals. The first one, the one we did 50 years ago, was written as a musical, but we never actually had a book with it, but we had all the songs. And this and the current one, the contemporary one, it's, you know, there's lots of stuff to write about now, and, you know, we have the perspective of people who are older, and so it will be different to how we were 50 years ago. But I think there's a thread running through all the stuff that we've done, and that's what I'd really like to investigate by doing these two albums simultaneously.
Exciting. Does it sound very weird to hear you say stuff that we wrote 50 years ago? Does that sound bizarre to you?
No, you mentioned it. It does sound really weird, doesn't it?
It's funny. I sit there. I am 60, and I sit there and I laugh. I go, but I really feel like 35. I, you know, obviously I don't move as fast as I did when I was 35, but it's time flies. And certainly with COVID, it turned around and sort of warped your sense of time, I guess, over the last couple of years.
Everybody's sense of time is gone. Honestly, it's such a weird thing.
That's for sure. Well, I'll tell you, I would be remiss in not mentioning that we are speaking actually on the day after the death of Queen Elizabeth II. And I mean, how are things in the UK right now?
I think a lot of people are sad that this figure, you know, if you're anything up to 70 years old or maybe a bit older, she would have been a constant in your life, firstly. Secondly, this is a big changing of the guard for us. For that reason, for that continuity that she represents to all of us, and I myself am a Republican for, you know, what should happen to the UK, but I hold no ill will against them, and I'm sad to see her go.
Well, did you ever perform for her in your career? Or that you know of?
No. No, I've never met her, but, you know, I understand she's a very nice person.
Right. Well, as a resident of the UK and a citizen there, is the monarchy in good hands with King Charles and Prince William in the wings, do you think?
We'll certainly see.
I guess so. There's all sorts of talk about how it's going to be changing with the younger people. And I was talking to my daughter the other day, and we were saying, my gosh, you know, this is, you know, her with 70 years on the throne, it's been almost a century of the way it's always been. And, you know, now you've got younger thoughts, younger things. I mean, just look at technology. I mean, we're talking on some crazy cell phones on internets across oceans, and stuff, you know.
Yeah, exactly. So perhaps the royal family should start going on TikTok more. I think that would be my solution to getting across the kids.
I have never had the opportunity to see Squeeze live, and I am so looking forward to seeing you here in Annapolis on the 27th at Ram's Head on Stage. Again, tickets, ramsheadonstage.com. And you do want to check out Glenn's site at glenntilbrook.com. And again, two N's in Glenn and one L in Tilbrook. And, you know, before we hang up, there is one thing I just want to ask you. But, I mean, you have such a catalog of songs over 50 years. Is there a song, whether it be new or old or somewhere in between, maybe it's personal, maybe it's a crowd reaction, but something that is just so timeless for you that you never get tired of playing?
I'm going to say there's a song called Nirvana on Cradle to the Grave record. That's 7 years old. And that's a very, very archetypal Squeeze song. And I love that. Of the older ones, you know, Tempted keeps on giving as a song. You know, I'm very proud of that. And yeah, it feels like almost nothing's due with me anymore because it's so long ago. But every time I play it, I love it.
Thank you so much. We are on the phone with Glenn Tilbrook. He is going to be here at Ram's Head on Stage on September 27th. The show is at 8 o'clock. The doors are at 7. There are still some tickets available at ramsheadonstage.com. Glenn's going to be there, obviously. I'm going to be there. And hopefully anybody who's listening to this will be there as well. But thank you so much, and safe travels across the pond, I guess.
Cool. Thank you, John. It's been such a pleasure talking to you.
Take care, Glenn. Thank you so much.
Cheers. Bye. To find something to say.
It drove them around the twist. They both were wondering what they might have missed. He quibbled with ambition. She fell into a rut. They sat and read the papers. In secret they were tucked. The creepy realization.
This has been a bonus podcast from Ion Annapolis. Please visit us at ionannapolis.net. Follow us on Facebook at All Annapolis and on Twitter at Ion Annapolis. And if you haven't subscribed to the Daily News Brief podcast, go for it. And all of your local news will be delivered to your phone, tablet, or smart device by 6 a.m. every Monday through Friday.